welcome back to Flipping English and the final section. We're on the home straight of our series on essay writing, and today we're going to be looking at the editing stage. So do you have to do editing? Absolutely you do. In an exam situation, you only get one crack. It's a first draft. However, if you get a paper that you can take home and write, you should edit and re-edit and re-edit and re-edit. And get that essay and polish it and get it as good as it possibly can be. And today we're going to be teaching you some tips to help you with that editing process. Now, before we get into that, I want my students to again reflect on their learning from the previous lesson, which was on writing a conclusion. So I want them to think about three things that make for a quality conclusion. I want you to write those three things down in the comment section below, and as always, imagine that you're teaching someone else. So you're writing down tips, a how-to, your own little how-to on how to write a conclusion. Right, so we'll pause and do that. Brilliant, out of pause, and we're into our editing. Tip number one for when you are editing your essay, read your essay out loud. You won't believe how much this will help, because you'll just be unable to read a sentence. And you'll go, well, that doesn't work, and you look at it and go, oh, that's grammatically incorrect, so that's why I can't read it. And it will just help you. Or I've used the same word. It won't sound right. So listen to the sound of yourself reading out that essay. And you'll pick up lots of problems with your writing through that reading process. And so once you pick up a problem, rewrite it there. The next thing that we're going to teach is going to be reverse havoc. So the C, we'll see how I go at doing it backwards. The C is for your content. O is for organisation. V is for the vocabulary used within the essay. The A is for accuracy. So that's accuracy of grammar, or accuracy of punctuation, of spelling. And finally, the H is for hedging. And that's where you want to avoid making really sweeping statements, which may or may not be true. So you go back and you find those and you maybe change it slightly, so maybe you say sometimes or arguably, rather than just saying something sweeping in general. You use the language which and I think that makes for a stronger essay without those sweeping statements. So with all that said, let's have a look at it. Right, editing an essay, let's go. So this is the finished product, well, the first draft anyway, of the Hunger Games essay. And I've just gone through and I've colour-coded each of the paragraphs from introduction through body paragraphs and into conclusion. And that will make the editing process easier, which is what we're doing here with Reverse Havoc, where we start looking at the content, which I believe is the most important part of this editing. Then we go into organisation, vocabulary, accuracy and hedging. And so doing all these things is just really going to polish your essay and create the best possible result. So starting with content, you need to check that the essay has a thesis statement and topic sentences that answer the question. So you need to go back to the question, which was, how does the Hunger Game explore that concept of survival? And you need to talk about themes, setting, characters and language techniques. So the thesis statement was that Katniss's need to protect the vulnerable is the most fundamental element of her personality, and it remains unchanged throughout the novel. That's a tick. Katniss's actions are driven by her desire to protect and provide for her family, principally Prim. Tick. Although confronted with the prospect of her imminent death after the reaping, Katniss's primary concern is Prim's well-being. Tick. The experience of being a tribute does not change Katniss. Tick. So all these paragraphs so far have talked about survival, which is why I'm giving them ticks. Katniss and Peter's victory in the arena places District 12 in dire danger. Tick, it's talking about the survival of the whole district. So look, what I'm doing now is I'm just making sure that I'm looking at themes. So there's inequality to start off. I'm just going through and highlighting in yellow all the different themes. We'll go to freedom here. Love is a theme, obviously. Katniss's love of Prim. We've got the survival itself is a theme. We've got the individual against society as a theme. Now I had to look at settings, so I'm going through and checking out the settings of the arena, of District 12, and also of the capital. Now I'm
doing going through the characters. I have talked about the characters. Here they are. I can see them. Now I'm going into language techniques. So that was paradoxes, symbolism, and illusion. So I've answered the brief of the essay. The next thing I want to check is the organisation of the essay. So what I'm looking for here are conjunctions and linking words, because I want it to be very clearly signposted, the essay. So these are examples of conjunctions, like fanboys. Linking words, however, nevertheless, or furthermore, are examples of linking words. Now, the best advice I can give you is to read your essay out loud. This will really help. It's going to help with your vocabulary, because if you're repeating the same words, it will be obvious when you read it out loud. It's going to help you with your accuracy. Spelling will be off, punctuation will be off, it won't read properly. So read it out loud. And finally, avoid hedging, and that's generalizations and stereotypes. They will weaken your essay.
Okay, welcome back. So just to recap what we've learnt in today's lesson, we've gone over editing, and we said, look, first thing to do, read your essay out loud. Okay, and then rewrite. The second thing we looked at for editing was the reverse havoc principle. So we're checking the content. So the content consists of your topic sentences and your thesis statement. Are they answering the question? Going through that. Then we're going into organization. We're using things like conjunctions and linking phrases and linking words just to act as signposts throughout your essay. Then we're looking at vocabulary. So you're not using the same word more than once in a sentence. Find a synonym. You're not using the same word at the start of consecutive sentences. You're slightly rewriting it, and that will make your writing more interesting. The A is for accuracy. And the H is for hedging, where you're not making sweeping statements. So all said that, thank you. I hope you've watched all five of our videos on writing essays. I hope you've got a lot out of them. Thank you for all those people who have written comments down below. And yes, keep learning. Okay, thanks for watching.